In this video, I will discuss the main areas within AML and financial crime prevention that are affected by technologies across the private and public sector. I will also discuss three of the main technologies to combat money laundering and how those are affecting and benefiting AML and financial crime prevention teams. But before we dive into it, if you are finding valuable this video, make sure you subscribe to FinCrime Agent and press the thumb up on the video. This will make it super easy for you to consume new videos that are going live on my channel, and it will allow me to create more contents for you. So let's jump right into today's video. Hi, I'm Marco Beranzoni and this is FinCrime Agent, my YouTube channel where every week I publish a new video for you to boost your awareness about anti-money laundering and financial crime prevention. The use of technology is one of the answers to make anti-money laundering and anti-terrorist financing operations more effective, quicker, and less expensive. What's your view on this? Do you think the industry is leveraging enough the available technologies to combat money laundering? Let me know your opinion in the video comments right below. In July 2021, also FATF released new comprehensive research highlighting benefits for the implementation of technologies across the private and public sectors to combat money laundering and terrorist financing. Before we start talking about specific technologies adopted in the AML and financial crime prevention sector, I'd like to share with you some key areas affected by technologies. My summary here across the private and public sector is in line with the FATF research document called Opportunities and Challenges of New Technologies for AML CFTs, which you can find in the description of my video. Within the private sector, the use of technologies to combat money laundering can bring significant advantages in several areas. Those include transaction monitoring, sanction screening, client onboarding, the cost of compliance operations, the volume of defensive regulatory reports, repetitive tasks, and more quality work for compliance staff. On the other hand, also the public sector can see many benefits when technologies to combat money laundering are in place. Those include the ability to support and overview more entities, faster response and actions when non-complying firms are identified, more efficient data processing and storage, and enabling information sharing. So, which are the three key technologies to combat money laundering? First position, artificial intelligence and machine learning. The ability to learn and optimize existing processes is fundamental to making more efficient and effective risk identification in the financial crime space. Several applications of AI and machine learning are already in place in the financial crime sector, helping the industry to operate faster and more securely. Here are some of the most common applications of AI and machine learning within the AML sector. False positives. A known issue is the volume of false positives, which increases the operational costs as well as the chances of missing actual risks. The use of machine learning here can bring tangible results, increasing the efficiency of the systems used and the time spent by staff reviewing non-productive alerts. CDD and KYC. The use of artificial intelligence and machine learning allows the ID verification of customers to take place in less time. Also, the actual verification of submitted documents can be automated and cross-checked by solutions capable to identify fakes in a more efficient way than a human eye. Ongoing customer monitoring. Patterns and client activities can vary significantly across customer types, geographies, and sectors. Personalized profiling of customer activities performed within the use of AI can make the detection of suspicious activities more precise and relevant for each customer. Graph analytics, which is also what I call connecting the dots. In many cases, unstructured data can lead to very valuable information to identify financial crime risks. The use of AI can simply allow visualization of the risks at the entity resolution level, using data points that are apparently unrelated. This is a key aspect for uncovering more complex money laundering activities, for example, in the trade finance sector or for predicate offense like human trafficking or sex exploitation that are often more difficult to identify. Automated reporting. One more area where AI and machine learning can operate well is in the automation of regulatory reporting. For jurisdictions open to this type of automation, the technologies to combat money laundering can simplify how suspicious activity reports are prepared and also submitted to the supervisor agencies. In my second position, I'm going to place the distributed ledger technology, which is also known as DLT. In fact, this is another application of technologies to combat money laundering, and customer onboarding is one of the areas that could be affected, particularly in the KYC space. Customers at the moment are still facing delays during the onboarding process that could be avoided thanks to the creation of a chronological decentralized interbank ledger that could be used by financial institutions in need to perform identical KYC verifications on the same customer. So the use of DLT would allow financial institutions to leverage the results of the KYC process that was successfully completed for that customer and reducing the customer friction and delays at the onboarding phase. This approach could make the overall KYC process much more affordable across regulated institution, as the verification will be performed only once, as the DLT record of the customer will be seen like a single point of truth. At the time of recording this video, there are already a number of organizations and financial institutions testing this idea, working on proof of concept in order to roll out this approach in the very near future. Trade-based money laundering is another area that could be possibly affected by this type of technology. In the trade finance sector, the dependence on paper-based processes are still in use and is responsible for most of the blame for trade-based money laundering activities. Additionally, as part of a more globalized economy, trade networks and supply chains are becoming more complicated due to red tapes and the volume of the parties that are involved. Many of the issues that contribute to forming weak points in supply chains may be addressed using blockchain technology. Decentralized distributed ledgers can improve visibility throughout the whole trade network, making trade money laundering techniques easier to be identified. Additionally, DLT technologies used in supply chains may help to verify that correct data are provided concerning the provenance and source of the goods involved in the deal. In third position, I'm going to include cloud computing. Cloud computing technology generally comprises three core services: software as a service, infrastructure as a service, and platform as a service. Thanks to the latest cloud technology, many financial institutions already managed to boost their productivity and reduce expenses for creating IT infrastructure required to run anti-money laundering solutions. From the data management aspect, the deployment of a cloud service can particularly benefit the harmonization of data sources, either internal or from third parties. For example, it's not unusual for an analyst to consume data from a significant number of internal and external systems when completing know your customers, beneficial ownership, or other type of AML investigations. The way that users can access, combine, and eventually augment essential data is much easier when organizations decide to implement a cloud computing approach. One more advantage of cloud computing includes better risk scoring capabilities, especially now that intelligent risk systems can learn from data over time. Also, it's worth noting that all data security concerns are gradually disappearing as private cloud deployments are being proven to be extremely secure even for the hosting of AML related data. And cloud computing was the last one I picked across all technologies to combat money laundering. So with that, I'm at the end of today's video. If this video was useful to you, you can show your appreciation and support my channel by subscribing to FinCrime Agent and press the thumb up on this video. Also, remember to check the description of this video where you will find the useful links, including how to become part of our community on patreon.com. And lastly, thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed my video, and until next time, see you soon.